हु इज ट्रेबल टॉपिक मास्टर? ओके,
नेल्सन।
नेल्सन, इफ वी नीड गेट लेट आई विल इनवाइट यू। ओके,
Shall I start? Vinny.
Yes.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and honored guest. I, Sushma, Sergeant at Arms, welcome you all to the meeting number 627 of Speech Weavers Toastmasters Club, Bangalore. To reach greater heights, we all should have a clear mission. Likewise, Toastmasters' mission is to provide a supportive and positive learning experience in which members are empowered to develop communication and leadership skills, resulting in greater self-confidence and personal growth. In all our Toastmasters meeting, we follow few golden rules. Please do not talk about sex, religion, and politics, which would offend others. If you are not a speaker, keep your microphone muted at all times. For better experience, keep your video on at all times unless you are moving in and out of the room. As an encouragement to all our role takers and speakers, make sure you upload them virtually. Now it's time to introduce our club president, who is a great coach for buddy Toastmasters, Taskmaster, and having an aspiration to become a good leader. He is an instrumental in bringing subject matters expert from various fields to impart the knowledge and enhance thought process to our fellow Toastmasters. His roles include, he is a past VP membership and immediate past VP education, currently working for a startup company as a business manager. His hobbies include cycling and enjoys reading books at his free time. Please join me welcoming our club president, Toastmaster Mayur. Toastmaster Mayur, over to you.
Thank you so much, Sushma, for your wonderful introduction. I'm very happy today. I hope you guys are doing well as well. Good evening, everybody. How are you guys?
Great. Great.
Thank you. So I open meeting number 627. Now before going for with my speech, I would like to invite our joke master, and she is the doodler, UX designer, and current secretary of our club. And I'm hoping she will be helping us with lot. She will be delivering a lot of good jokes for us, and hope and everyone will enjoy. I would like to welcome our club secretary, Toastmaster Vandana. Over to you.
That's a lot of pressure, Mayur. So the thing is, I'm not feeling very funny. So last time Vinu asked me to be the joke master, and I'm like, this week is not funny. It's a lot of crying. So let me take it up next week. Because I agreed to do it, I have to do it this week. How many of you are single here? Okay. He hesitated, so it's not sure. Yes, Mr. Joseph, our youngest single person. So what is like the most common question that people ask you? You're on
when
mute.
When you are getting married.
I am.
When you are getting married.
So because of this question constantly being asked, and because of some of the conversations that just happened before this meeting started, I thought maybe I should start my joke with this. Basically, everyone kept asking my parents, when you getting her married? People at work were asking me. So finally, a guy showed some kind of interest to get married or consider getting married to me. But I didn't know about the story. So I was working in Cochin, and my brother stays in Bombay. So one day, my parents, they were visiting my brother, and they asked me to fly down. So I was like, okay, fine. I'll just go there. I mean, I can hardly take leave. And because according to my manager, taking leave is like asking for ancestral property, you know, my share of the ancestral property. So basically, I just go there, I fly down, and then I'm sleeping. And then, you know, I love chart. So my brother takes me to this excellent chart place. And then, you know, for me, it's like anything chocolate, which is very dark. So he takes me to the best place. They manage to disappoint me a bit, but then it happens. Finally, I come and then I go to sleep. And in the morning, my mother's waking me up. And then she tells me, this wake up, get ready. This lady and her brother, they're coming to see you. And I'm like, so much of love. Come visit your brother, your parents. We'll all be together. And this was exactly the purpose that, you know, was meant to be served on my trip down to Bombay. So I just come there and then finally, so my entire purpose in life was not to get married at that point. So I'm not sure about the time. Is my time up?
Yeah, I think it's 2 minutes. 2 minutes only.
Oh, okay, fine. So the point is, I did stand in front of a guy and he asked me why my hair was short. And the whole point was, I didn't want to get married. So I said that to him and thankfully, I continued my life, not being married, at least for some time. Back to you, Toastmaster. Back to you, President.
Thank you so much, Vandana, for entertaining us with your jokes. And now I would like to talk about intelligence. So intelligence has been a controversial topic throughout psychology history. Despite the substantial interest in the subject, there is still considerable disagreement about what component makes intelligence. Intelligence involves some different mental abilities, logic, reasoning, problem solving, and planning. While the subject of intelligence is one of the largest and most heavily researched, it is one of the topics that generate greatest controversies as well. While psychologists often disagree about the definition and cause of intelligence, research on intelligence plays a significant role in many areas. These areas include decision rewarding, how much funding should be given to educational program, the use of testing to screen job applicant, and the use of testing to identify children who need additional academic help. The term intelligence quotient or IQ was first coined in the early 20th century by a German psychologist named William Stern. How many of you know this person? Okay. Different researchers have proposed a variety of theories to explain the nature of intelligence. And there are some of the major theory of intelligence that have emerged during the last 100 years, which include general intelligence, as British psychologist Charles Spearman described a concept as he referred to as a general intelligence or G factor.
Sorry, I couldn't quite get
it. After using a technique known as a factor analysis to examine some of mental aptitude tests, Spearman concluded that score on this test were remarkably similar. And other is primary mental abilities. Mental abilities, which was derived by Lewis L. Thurstone, offered a different theory of intelligence instead of viewing intelligence as a single general ability. Thurstone theory focused on 7 different primary mental abilities, which include associative memory, numerical ability, which most of us heard about it, perceptual speed, reasoning, spatial visualization, verbal comprehension, word fluency, etc. Okay, thank you. And now I have a few announcements to make. First one is our newsletter deadline is 15th September, if you want to submit article and which will be incorporated in our newsletter. So please prepare your article well. Research your article very well and write. And if you have any doubt, do reach out to our VP PR, VP Education or me anytime. And I request you, whoever is submitting the article, please thoroughly check your grammar once, either first by yourself, and secondly on you can check, take help of any member or take help of online software, including Grammarly or Ginger. Second announcement I have to make is that we are going to have a table topic contest on 24th September. Akash, could you share the poster? Yes. So please be ready, guys, as we will be having contest on 24th September, and in October 8th or 9th, we will be having our area level contest. So prepare well, and because this is not going to be an easy task, because a lot of members won already last year in the for division level, and they went for division level as well. Okay, next announcement I have to make is to for 421, which is contest training. So to be do you want to do any role in contest, you can take. Also there will be judges training if you have completed your level 2 in your pathway. So I would request you to please go to, please attend the judges training so you can participate as a judge in any club or various event which will be organized by state, area or division level. The next and very important announcement is we have opened our club renewal for the term October, March, and it will close on
use my
my connection was I was got this where I got disconnected. Could anybody tell me?
You were talking about term renewals.
Yeah, so the term renewal will term renewals are open and it will close for on 15 September. So please renew your membership as soon as possible. Now I would like to, before jumping into inviting our Toastmaster of the day, I would like to take who else is joining us. Where are you from joining us, Oryajit?
Hi, Mayur and the club. I am Arijit. I belong to Hoodie Toastmasters Club, which incidentally is going to celebrate its 100th meeting tomorrow. I will be giving the link to one or two of my friends in this club, and they can circulate you for you to attend tomorrow. And I have been part of your meetings before. I have attended twice. And the reason why I look forward to your meetings is that your club makes wonderful posters and sends beautiful emails. That is one reason I joined today. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Oryajit, for joining us. I would like to thank also our guest, Pallav, Harshal, and Ilangan, for joining us. Thank you for joining us, guys. Now I would like to invite, without further ado, I'm going to invite the Toastmaster of the day. He is going to talk about building trust with conversational intelligence. He's a passionate life and digital coach. He has around 2 decades of corporate IT experience. He is also volunteering as a chief coach for personal growth startup Unlimited Potential Insight. He is a Toastmaster since 8 years and has finished his CCCL in his pathway. he has also played a role of club.
I think that was already a long introduction. I can take over. Looks like President Mayur has some challenges on the network side. I see you there, President Mayur.
I think I have a lot of glitches. Just a second.
Okay.
Okay, guys, can you hear me?
Yes, I think introduction was, we already heard the introduction. So
okay, okay. So you can take over. Over to you, Vineet.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Mayur. And thank you so much, President Mayur. So fellow Toastmasters and dear guests, it's my privilege and pleasure to welcome you all to this Speech Weavers Toastmasters Club. For the benefit of guests, let me give a high-level structure of the meeting today. Before we talk about the theme, and the meeting goes this way, that we have two prepared speeches where a member will delivering the speeches based on the projects that they have chosen. There will be a table topic session round where members and even guests can practice impromptu speeches. And then we'll have evaluation for the prepared speeches wherein general evaluator and the team of TAG will be giving evaluation. And the theme of the day is building trust with conversational intelligence. President Mayur talked about intelligence, but I'm not going to talk about intelligence. I'm going to talk about conversational intelligence. Has anyone heard this word, conversation? I know you might have heard about emotional intelligence. You might have heard about IQ, EQ, but has anyone heard about conversational intelligence? Can you raise your hand if anyone has heard? Or is it a completely new word for you? Joke Master Vandana has heard. Awesome. Someone is there so who can, you know, kind of support me on in this country. It was a completely new word for me also when I actually went through this world. So there's a very amazing kind of context on this. So there was a research that was done, and out of which 9 of 10 conversations were missing their mark completely. So just think about it. When we are doing conversation, out of 10, 9 were completely missing the mark. And the person on the other end of your conversation does not even receive the intended message 90% of the times. And through decades of research, organizational anthropologist named Judith Glaser, she learned this technique, and wherein the idea was to how to choose the right word in the right conversation, in the conversation. Every interaction contains signals that create either trust and connection, or it can create distrust and fear. And she shared all her learnings in this amazing book called Conversational Intelligence. And that's where from the word derived from. And now it is one of the big workshop that happens in any leadership workshops. So it's called, that's where this word came from, conversational intelligence. And I thought as a Toastmaster, this is so important for us because it deals with communication. Think about a couple of conversation that might have impacted you. Let's talk about a feel bad conversation. Think about a moment when you've been called out unfairly, maybe in a Toastmaster meeting or maybe in your corporate meeting. Good that we are not doing that in Toastmasters meeting, but it may happen in the corporate meeting. You are blamed for something which you have not even done. You feel angry about that person, that you, why he's attacking me, why she's attacking me. You want to fight back. You want to bolt out of the room or maybe crawl under the table. Something you want to do. And now think about some feel-good conversation. The first step towards feeling good in a conversation is to remove fear and distrust. You naturally feel free to be open. You don't feel, you without any defensiveness, any avoidance or being attacked. And the next thing that happens is you start to connect. In a relaxed state, the brain is open to sharing and connecting with others. So that's where I thought, I think conversational skill is something that is, the conversational intelligence is something that can connect with all of us. I wrote a ebook also around that, and I'll share a link if somebody want to download and read through that. But I thought this is something that will really help all of us. With that, let's move on to the first important part of this Toastmaster meeting, and which is prepared speeches. I don't know if Toastmaster Shubhadeep had joined. He pinged me that he will be late. So he was the first speaker, President Mayur. So I think, shall we, I don't know if...
Yes, you can go for second speaker.
Okay. So the second speaker will be attempting innovative pathway level 5 completion. And a second speech. So to evaluate his speech, we have Toastmaster Akash. Toastmaster Akash, can you read out the speech objective?
The tag team introduction we need to do, right?
Okay, I'm sorry. Let me invite General Evaluator is there. I'm sorry. Yeah, so let us first invite, let me talk about, so one of the important part of any session or any conversation that we do is feedback. And we in Toastmasters, we have General Evaluator who is going to evaluate everything that is going to happen in this meeting. And he also has a team of tag who will be helping him out. And today's General Evaluator is Hitendra, Dr. Toastmaster Hitendra. And I was just talking to him and he said he's a very fun-loving and energetic person. And I found him when I was talking with him. His life motto is to be happy and spread the happiness. He believes in continuous improvement and has recently taken VP education role as well in the iSpeak Club. About conversation with trust, he says building trust with conversation is really important, even though he's himself a very hesitant guy to start a conversation, but he believes that conversation are must to know someone and trust comes only after knowing someone. So over to you, Toastmaster and Mr. G. Hitendra.
Thank you for kind introduction, Toastmaster of the day, Vinit. And I was so happy, you know, when you moved on to the speeches. Oh, I don't have to do my job today. I'm so happy I can just listen and enjoy the session. So yeah, as Vinit said, I believe in continuous improvement. And obviously, nothing is perfect. Anybody, you will always find some or the other thing to improve. So I'm here to see how the session runs. And more than feedback, I would say those will be improvement items. Or maybe, you know, good things about the session that you must be proud of towards the end. And since I cannot do all the bad mouthing, right? So I need support from others. So I have a team of tag. And we have Toastmaster Nitin as the timer today. If Toastmaster Nitin, if you can introduce your role today.
Yeah. Thank you, General Evaluator. A very warm and very good evening to all the Toastmasters and the guests. As the timer, my role is to remind each role taker, speakers, and to strictly allow the time for you. To help you to maintain the time, I will flash the following lights. If you see here, I will flash the blue light while you started your speech, green light for the speeches, prepared speeches. At 5 minutes, I'll put the green light. At 5.5 minutes, I'll put the yellow light. And at the 6 minute, I will put the red light. And you will be having a 1 more minute of extinction. And for other speakers, which are up to 2 to 3 minutes, at 2 minutes, I'll project a green screen. At 2.5 minutes, I'll project a yellow screen. And at 3 minutes, it is your final call, which is a red screen. And you will be having a 30 seconds of the time, which you can extend up to. So at the end of the meeting, I'll be presenting my report. So thank you and back to General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nitin. That was a great introduction. Is everybody able to pin Toastmaster Nitin? In case you are not, if you have any presentation, if you are not able to see, we may have to see if we can do some audible sound or something like that. I'm assuming everybody, all speakers are able to pin Toastmaster Nitin. Next is
I cannot spin because I am in the mobile.
Oh, okay. So maybe Toastmaster Nitin, if you can make some sound, bell or something at the 5th minute, 6 minute and 7th minute, it will be great.
Yeah,
if
sure.
We can make some
arrangement. Zoom Master can pin me.
Okay. Yeah. Let's see how it goes, but let's try it. Let's confirm that with the speaker.
I'll try it. Yeah. Sure. Okay.
Thank you. Let's move to the AHA counter. We have Toastmaster Adarsh today as AHA counter. If you can explain your role, Toastmaster Adarsh.
Greetings to all Toastmasters and guests. I'll be playing the role of an AHA counter today. And the role of an AHA counter is quite different. It's unique. And I believe that as my role as the AHA counter, I'm supposed to point out certain crutch words that stop us from making our speeches and table topics refined. And refinement is key when you want to provide a table topic or a speech, because it keeps things going. It helps deliver a speech or a table topic in the most soothing way possible. And that's what my job is all about. So I'll be pointing out catch words such as ah, you know, so, and even and is a crutch word, believe it or not, because it's something that most people use when they don't even finish a sentence. So it's something that we'll be working on today, and I'll be presenting my report towards the end of the session. For now, back to you, Jindabharata.
Thank you, Toastmaster Adarsh. And let's move to Grammarian Toastmaster Varsha, if you can introduce your role for today.
Yeah, Hitendra, we have one changes as a grammarian. So Toastmaster Joseph is the grammarian.
Okay, Toastmaster Joseph, if you can introduce your role today.
As a grammarian, I would be looking into the phrases and some of the good words that has been spoken during the speech. And also, I will also look into what are the grammar mistakes, either in pronunciation or in the word construction. I will be pointing out that also. At the end of the session, if I am called, I will be reporting to you. Over to you, General Bhatt. Thank you.
Toastmaster Joseph, would you like to introduce word of the day?
The word of the day is,
bagrages. Okay.
Word of the.
I think somebody highlighted. Maybe do you want to talk about it? TM Mayur or someone, I think somebody said the word.
Yeah, so the word of the day is bagrages, meaning give reluctantly or resentfully. For example, after what he has been through, it's hard to begrudges him the money he has.
Okay, our thank day. You, Toastmaster Mayur, for helping Grammarian Joseph.
Thanks yeah, I was lot. Taken just a moment. I took the grammarian post. That's why I
could understood. Yeah, thank you for thank you for your willingness to take up the post. So, without any further ado, I think I will transfer the control back to T-Mod Vinith for rest of the sessions. Looking forward to it. Thank you all.
Toastmaster Hitendra, you already gave an example of conversational intelligence. I don't want to badmouth myself. I have a team. Good funny note. All right, so let's move to the most important section of any Toastmasters meeting, and that is the prepared speeches. And the first speaker that we have, I'm repeating that again, that he'll be attempting innovative pathway level. And which is second speech from level 5, and we have a evaluator for him, which is Toastmaster Akash. Toastmaster Akash, can I request you to please read out the speech objectives?
Thank you, Toastmaster Vinith. The purpose of this project is for the member to apply his or her leadership and planning knowledge to develop a project plan, organize a guidance committee, and implement the plan with the help of a team. The purpose of this second speech is for the member to share some aspect of his or her experience on completing the project. This is a innovation pathway pathway.
Second.
Back to you, Toastmaster.
All right. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Akash. And Toastmaster Joseph, does he need any introduction? He's the most experienced guy, on top of it, the most energetic guy in this club. So I always get inspired by seeing so many things that he keeps doing, international clubs and all the things, the kind of awards he gets. And when I was talking with him, what he thinks about conversational intelligence, and he said some great insightful line. He said conversations are key to engaging and creating relationships. Any conversation is a building block to what you are looking to achieve, and respect to building a relationship, love, business, corporate. So let's put our hands together for Toastmaster Joseph
Toastmaster Joseph, Endeavor, Endeavor, Toastmaster Joseph.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Perfectly fine.
Visible?
Yes, visible and audible.
Thank you so much. Laughter, learning, and living. That was the theme. I still remember. And it was a great accomplishment of the speech on that day, and especially for me. Good evening, Toastmasters, and my dear guest. My vision, having reached the level 5 innovative pathway, it's mandatory, as well as my desire to do the high proficiency leadership in an enamored and enchantment signifying the theme of laughter, learning, and living. The project plan. I prepared a roadmap for this project by appointing the guidance committee, all advisors needed for the event, for the milestone meeting. The guidance committee members were area director Srinu Babu, past president DTM Milanji, and outgoing president TM Deepa, secretary Vandana, president elect Mayur, Toastmasters Subhadeep and Akash, and VP Education elect Veenu Karthi. With the advice of the guidance committee, the milestone meeting was planned on 25th of June 2021. For the achievement of the project plan, the roadmap were discussed with the guidance committee in the following components. That is, 4 components: the obtained resources, allocate budget, effective key deliveries, meeting of milestones. The resources: training completion of the pathway from the base camp, contacting recently completed contestant from District 92. Toastmaster Matthew Verghese from District 92 is an evaluation contest in 2019 champion and table topic winner 2019, humorous speech contest in 2021. Is selected as a keynote speaker. In order to have more humor and fun, we arranged a panel discussion with humorous speech contest winners, for which we have selected Toastmaster Rahul Gopi and DTM Arokya Nitya. TM Rahul Gopi, the champion of humor speech, is also a senior software engineer at Cisco, and DTM Arokya Nitya is the second runner-up humorous speech in the year 2021. Is a quality analysis lead by profession and an entrepreneur by passion. For the panel discussion, Matthew Verghese also joined. Allocation of budget for the event's availability was ensured for all purpose of the expenses to be incurred. Deliverables such as preparation of posters and its publication at consecutive intervals, along with the invitation to the guests through email as a reminder for the event to be conducted on the 25th June 2021. Collection of photographs as well as credentials from the participants were obtained well in advance for the publication. The milestones achieved was 3 meetings were held on the planning of the event for the acceptance of the members' involvement, selection of the participants for the event, fixing the date of events at milestone meeting number 620 on June 25, 2021. Publication of the posters and invitations 23rd, 24th of June 2021. After completion of the entire event planning, the first speech on the accomplishment was delivered to the club in one of the earlier meetings. Allocating the role takers for the event day was selected and rehearsals were conducted for its proper compliance. A standby arrangement was also made to cope up with the network failure. The event day, the 620th meeting was well commenced with full energy hour by Sergeant at Arms Toastmaster Neelu, followed by Toastmaster Deepa and outgoing presidential address, giving a tenure of achievements and accomplishments both in person as well as by the club, which was later appreciated by DTM Matthews Verghese during the keynote speech. As an event of the chair, I have taken up the lead in briefing about the theme Laughter, Learning, and Living, and a brief history of the Toastmaster International. Later, introducing the chief guest, DTM Matthews Varghese, the keynote speaker who spoke on the title, Toastmaster Make It Count. The speech was to indulge in motivating the membership enrollments in our Speech Weavers Club. It was a great, fabulous speech, carrying enormous wisdom to enjoy in depth. Also, it was pertinent that the audience had lots to take away from the session, which is filled with obsession, as well as releasing their minds, which was called learning. This was followed by panel discussion, Toastmaster Rahul Gopi, DTM Matthew Varghese, and DTM Aarogya Nithya was led by our DTM Milanji as a moderator. DTM Milanji has meticulously conducted these humorous questions to the panelists, one after the other, made everyone to laughter. The trio were entertaining us with a great humor, making the evening more pleasant and impassioned as a fruitful gift of evergreen thoughts to each and every one of us. The graceful presence of nearly 100 guests marked the milestone meeting as a memorable one. This day will be most remembered by honoring our champions, and the comprehensive program was conducted by our club in history. I hope the audience would have begrudged the talents possessed by the great speakers of that day. The vote of thanks was presented by Subhadeep, exonerating the guest speakers as well as the distinguished guests on behalf of the Speech Weavers Club. Acknowledged the event chair and the role takers, the guest speakers sent their adorable messages for our club following day. On this day, I thank all the members of the guidance committee for their wholehearted involvement. It was greatly palatable. I thank and exhilarated all the role takers on that day in showing their indefatigable energy in their performance contributed to the great success. Last but not the least, all the role takers, all the people who are Toastmaster who are presented in the club for their grateful presence on this occasion, make it a successful endeavor of the living. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
They say levels are in details, and the kind of details you shared is not easy to put in one speech, Toastmaster Joseph. A quite detailed report on how the event was done, and I really liked your sincerity and all the details that you gave. I'm sure we all have learned from each of the details that you have sent. Thank you so much for your speech. Let's move on to the next speaker, and the next speaker will be attempting level 2, project 3, Introduction to Mentoring from Leadership Development Module. And to evaluate his speech, we have Toastmaster Bidu. Toastmaster Bidu, may I request you to please read out the speech objective?
Thank you, Toastmasters of the day, Toastmasters Vineet. The member is attempting Pathway Level 2, Project 3, and is developing an understanding of Toastmasters Mentoring. The purpose of this project is for the member to clearly define how Toastmasters envisions mentoring. The purpose of the speech is for the member to share some aspects of previous experience as a protege. The speech is about a time when member was a protege himself. The mentor may discuss any aspect of the protege experience he had himself, but the speech should not be a report on the content of Introduction to Toastmasters Mentoring Project. I would like to intimate the timer, Toastmasters Nitin, that the speech is 5 to 7 minutes long. Over to you, Toastmasters of the day, Toastmasters Vineet.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Bidu. So the speaker is currently serving as Associate Area Director, Area B1. I'm sure most of you, or rather all of you, know him. He's a club coach of a corporate club, and he has lots of hobbies, playing guitar, learning keyboard, exercise, photography. And he recently started a podcast channel, Coffee and Chat with Subhadeep. Interesting, I have already subscribed to him. You all should do that, coffeechatwithsubhadeep.com. And when I was talking with him on a conversation, he said conversations are important to build. He truly believes that it is so important for building the trust. And with that, let's put our hands together for Toastmaster Shubhadeep. Topic is learning to be on stage. Toastmaster Shubhadeep, learning to be on stage, learning to be on stage. Toastmaster Shubhadeep.
Just give me one moment. I'll pin the timer. Give me one moment. Not able to. Nitin, can you pin yourself to my screen? I'm not getting the option.
Pardon me, what?
Yeah, that's fine. So I wanted someone to pin the timer on the screen. I don't have that option, not sure why. To pin Nitin on my screen. Mayu, can you do that?
Master will automatically pin at that time. Is that okay or you want?
Okay, that's fine. That's absolutely fine. All right.
Over to you, Toastmaster.
It was a contest. I still remember. Most likely the International Speech Contest of Adobe Toastmasters Club back in 2016. There was a speaker. She was illuminating, expressive, eloquent, and as if the words fell like a free-flowing waterfall fountain. And undoubtedly, she won the Best Speaker Award at our club level. Fellow Toastmasters and my dear guests, when I started my Toastmasters journey, I heard an award-winning speech by a wonderful speaker. And my intent was very simple. I wanted to be on stage one day, speak effortlessly. That's it. I reached out to the VPN membership and enrolled for Toastmasters on that very day after hearing the speaker. The club in those days was in its nascent stages and things were still evolving. And they were being straightened out. I was super excited and I reached out on one of the WhatsApp group to the VPA requesting a speech slot for the very next week after joining the club. Now, since the club was budding, it was evolving, limited members, and I got a speech slot immediately for the next week. But how far did I know that I was about to face with the biggest challenge of my life? I prepared an icebreaker, probably took around 2 to 3 hours to prepare the speech, to come on stage, to speak effortlessly. And when the Tier Modi, or the Toastmaster of the day, when that person called my name out, and I slowly started walking towards the stage, I felt the world was spinning, as if the end of days for me at least. And when I faced the crowd with just 7 people, I became numb, dead silence. Not a word came out of my mouth and my hands started literally shaking like this. I was not sure what to do. After that session of humiliation, I got a text from my club president introducing me to a person named Rupinder Singh, who would be my mentor. And he was not part of my club and I wasn't sure who Rupinder was at that point of time. And due to some reason, he reached out to my club president requesting that I should be mentor of Shubhadeep. So after my icebreaker, I still remember for my second, third and fourth speech, I was in touch with Rupinder. Rather, he reached out to me. And at that point of time in 2016, there was no pathway. It was a traditional Toastmaster module that we had. And he explained me very thoroughly during those days that every time a person gets a chance to be on that arena, to be on that stage, it's only a couple of minutes to prove oneself. Not only in Toastmasters, consider that in your corporate world, consider that on any platform that you are on. If you want to be successful, you'll get only a couple of minutes. And if you're not able to perform within those couple of minutes, we lose. That's a very important lesson which struck me during those days. And he always asked me as a feedback mechanism to record myself, rather video record myself, because I am the best critic about myself. Toastmasters provides a wonderful feedback mechanism, but if I want to be blunt, if I want to be blazoned with my own feedback, that's when I would need myself to be a critic of my own speeches. The impact of those discussions during initial days had a great impact and it was very effective. After my fourth speech, me and my mentor never crossed paths in terms of speech preparations since he became occupied, busy with other projects. But even today, if I'm delivering a very high level speech or anything as such, I just give him a quick thing. to ask him for any tips. Rupender Singh, as we all know, he was part of one of our keynote speeches. He's the second runner-up of International Speech Contest 2019. The reason I shared this story is the power of sensei, mentor, or teacher, if you may, is invaluable. We cannot begin to comprehend, we cannot fathom how much of a difference can a person make in your delivery style, in your leadership quality, in your confidence, if you have a mentor. And I myself, I'm live, a real example. Toastmasters is a great platform for us as a person to be aligned, a mentor in our initial days. And when we feel that we are on that experience stage wherein we have gathered, inculcated those experiences, it's time for us to share our experiences with the new joiners. We become mentees. Imagine this as a cycle of learning, which passes on from one person to another. One of the learnings that I have taken throughout my journey as a Toastmaster for these last 5 years is a mentor is that person who helps you to find hope within yourself. Thank you, and over to the Toastmaster of the day.
Wow. It was as if I was just going through the journey of Toastmaster, of my own journey of almost like last 7-8 years. Subhadeep, you started with, I'm not the evaluator, but I really enjoyed the whole journey that you expressed. It was as if it was so vivid that I was completely there. Thank you so much for amazing speech today, and I'm sure you can do a workshop on motivating people why they should be part of Toastmasters. When you talked about the mentorship, I'm fan of mentorship more than anything. I'm really fan of mentorship in Toastmasters, so I have learned a lot from the mentorship part. Thank you so much for that amazing speech. And coming to again on the conversation and intelligence, and I'm so happy, Subhadeep, somewhere connected with that only. Ultimately, if you want to become better communicator, again, better conversationalist, somewhere this Toastmasters is really helpful. So effective conversation creates the ability to build trust, not over month and years, but instantaneously. You have two people in full possession of their ability to create, empathize, reason, and plan. And the result is readiness and the ability to find solutions, no matter how difficult the subject matter is. There are three levels. I'll talk maybe in the next section when I have some time. So there are three levels of conversation and how it goes from positional to the transformational levels of conversation. I'll talk about in the next section. I'll not take much time, but let's come to the next section, next amazing section. And I see that many guests have joined a bit later, and this is an opportunity for everyone now, which is, the section is called Table Topics. And we have Nelson Jaikumar as the Table Topic Toastmaster, Nelson Jaikumar as the Table Topic Master. And I think he is one of the most humble guy I have talked to. When I was discussing with him, he was not ready to even share much introduction. And I said, give me at least 2-3 lines. What exactly? No, sir, you just say that I'm just a marketing professional having, more than a decade experience and working in hospitals and more towards healthcare domain. So, but he also mentioned that he's fan of, the reason he's part of Toastmasters because he want to go to the next level of his conversation. And that's where I completely connected with him. So let's invite Toastmaster Nelson for Table Topics. Over to you, Toastmaster Nelson.
Thank you, Tiyumadi.
Your voice is not audible. I don't know if it's only for me or it's very low. If you can.
Even for me.
Now?
Yeah, it's better now.
Better.
Yeah.
Good evening, fellow Toastmaster and guest. Today, that exciting session is a table topic session. That its purpose of that session is to improve our impromptu speech skill. How will it help? It will help to improve the skill in continue either meeting or conversation in minimal preparation time, and can be major asset both business and social. And also it will help you to attending some company function and engaging small talks and guests in social event. everywhere in your life, every each and part of that speech, your impromptu speech will help you. This is the platform to increase your impromptu speech skill. In Toastmasters Club, they are giving that a table topic session within 1 minute to 2 minute time. You can answer that unrehearsed questions and don't know that topics. So here we can help you. I hope all are eagerly waiting for that session. We go for that session. So first, I inviting that volunteer to participate that table topic session. So I request you to raise your hand. Yeah, Mr. Georgit.
Hi, Nilsha.
I giving you a question. Your question is, what are you different from other people? Hello.
Is the question me, Manish Gupta?
Yes, Manish Gupta. Yes.
What's the topic?
The topic I'll put in the chat box. Once again. So what do you do differently from other people? Your question.
Good evening, everybody. What do I do differently from other people? I start my day. I go for exercise. When I go for exercise, there are many people, those who come for a walk. In my town, they walk in a group. And they walk, sometimes they walk brisk, sometimes they walk slow. But I think they're also spending 1.5 hours every day. They go for a walk. And I also go to do exercise, but I work out like a beast. I don't waste my time talking to people at that time. The reason is that's our precious time. So I feel sometimes ecstatic that I am doing something different, which they are not doing it. So I am getting result. There are many people, those who come every day, and after that they have a pot belly. The reason is, after doing exercise also, some of them, if they walk out like a beast also, they eat like a pig, and that's all waste. So that is a thing which I do different from people. In my business also, I try to level my best. I can say I'm gifted by God, or it's by default. Nobody told me about this thing. I try to do something different, which nobody does it. So that's the reason I grab the attention of the people. So I feel pride of myself when somebody compliments me that this work which you have done it, nobody else has done it. That make my day. So if I get these type of compliment, the next day I try to do better than other and try to think out of the box, which other people are not doing it. So those are the things which I try to do different from others. I mean, everybody should try to do something different. And we have to do something different that people should copy from us. Then we should inspire people. Thank you. Over to the Toastmaster, please.
Thank you very much, Monish. It's nice impromptu speech, and not the coolest speech ever. And next, I going to that Orajit. That's Orajit. Your question is, Orajit, your question is, would you open an envelope that has the date of your death inside? What is your reaction?
Oh, I would be quite happy to know that I would be living for a few days and decided. I would actually look forward to which is the date. Is it near my birthday or something like that? That is a very weird thing of opening an envelope and seeing the date when you would pass away. Normally, I love envelopes for that matter of fact, especially when you slip some money into it. But those things are make it attractive. And if you were, I'm a little old, so I also was used to writing letters, put it in an envelope and send it to my relatives and things like that. But about death, I haven't, I don't think much about it. It's a very touchy topic, especially in the recent times we have encountered this quite often. On a sad note, a very good friend of mine, he was the president of our club and I was very close to him. And we were having conversations, quite intimate, very friendly conversations. And one day he tells me, he attends a meeting and we had a very nice meeting and we were exchanging greetings and things like that. But within 3 weeks of that conversation, he passed away. So you never know what is going to happen, but every moment you stay, you live, you make it better for others. You can inspire people. I remember Rajesh, he inspired me even at that moment. And I will always remember him with that last conversation. So if it is my death, so I will ensure that I can motivate, I can help people as much as I can. Thank you.
For that very nice answer, this person asked that Air Commander in that interview. Same question asked you. It's very nice explanation. Thank you. We go. Next, we move to that volunteer, Ms. T.M. Elango is there. Ms. T.M. Elango.
Hi, sir.
Your question is, would you be friends with yourself? Would you be friends with yourself?
Why not? I am the only person who loves me well. I am the only person who knows me well. I am the only person who has an ear to all my secrets. No one else, not my wife, not even my best friend, not my enemy, not my mother, not my sister, not my father, not even my son, not even you. No one knows my secrets. Only I know the secrets. More than the secrets, I know the pains, the struggles, the problems, the weird things I did, foolish and silly things I did, which I can't tell it now, you know. I can see Joseph, Toastmaster Joseph laughing at me. Yes, sir, I did so foolish things in my college days that I'm not ashamed of, actually. And I love myself for those very things which I am ashamed of. I love myself for all those mistakes that created, all the problems that I faced, all the struggles that I faced because of those problems, because of the mistakes, because of these shame things, I am what I am now. There's so much of imperfection in me. There is so much that I have to learn. And that's why I'm in Toastmasters, and that's why I'm attending this meeting as well. I love myself, but not only myself, I love others as well. Loving myself gives me the confidence that I should also love others, people like all of you, because you are going to help me love myself. Love is an amazing feeling. And everybody should love at least themselves so that you have need not depend on others. It's an unconditional love. Love yourselves. Love yourselves, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you very much, Elango. Nice speech and also body language, very nice. And next we go to TM Vandana. Your question is a tricky question. What is your greatest strength as a Toastmaster?
What is
your greatest strength as a Toastmaster?
I'm never satisfied. How many ever compliments that I get, I'm still not satisfied with how I do a role or how I deliver a table topic. You know, I have people telling, okay, you won, congratulations. But then I still go and look at my speech. I get the recorded version. I follow up, get the recording, find out how I did. I evaluate myself first. And then I take a snippet of the recording. I share it with one or two people who are experienced Toastmasters. I get their feedback. If I come second, I want to know why I came second. What are the things that I could have done differently? So not being satisfied, I think, is also my biggest strength, but also my weakness, because that means I don't learn to appreciate myself for having taken that risk, putting myself out there and still giving it my best. So a lot of times, even when people tell me, wow, you won, and I don't feel the same happiness that I should feel, or that, you know, that the way I should celebrate, I don't celebrate it enough. So sometimes I feel that I should not beat myself up too much, because there's so many things that are happening. I'm in a new job, you know, I have a little one who's so wonderful, but that's also a full-time job. So I sometimes try to take a step back and tell myself, Vandana, it's okay. You still did a good job. So sometimes it's about, you know, learning to appreciate yourself, which is a very difficult thing for me, which probably not many people know about me. But those who interact on one-on-one, or, you know, when they give me a compliment, I find it so hard to accept it, that, you know, I'm just laughing. So today morning, Vinu knew that I am Toastmaster of the Month for July, but he did tell me about it. He said, tomorrow, you know, it's a good day, religious day and all that. He told me about the importance of his festival over there. And I said about Onam. And then he surprised me with Toastmaster of the Month. Again, I was surprised. But I hope my strength does not become my weakness. What is your strength as a Toastmaster? Back to you.
Very nice speech, Anna. It's also motivate us, as ours also. Thank you, Miss. Next topic is ready. I need a volunteer to take this topic. Anybody want to take? I'm not seeing my face. Can you raise your hand? Last one topic. Yeah. Yes, TM Jyoti.
Milind is there. You can give me.
Yeah. The TM Jyoti is there. And I
okay.
TM Jyoti, your question is, what memory of your law, yours is the worst? What memory of yours is the worst?
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Nelson, for giving this wonderful topic to me and for everybody to be ready to listen to me for the next 2 minutes. In fact, when it comes to memories, I feel we shouldn't be putting a label on memories. Generally, there is a tendency, people say it's a good memory, it's a wonderful memory, it's a painful memory, or it's a suffering that actually keeps reminding people of the pain that they actually went through in that course of experience. What I feel differently is, everybody here at this club, that we shouldn't label any memory with a feeling or an experience, because every experience leaves you with a message. If we get something wonderful, we enjoy in that moment as well as in the years to come. When we do not get something from an experience, then we get a message. And if we label a memory or an experience with anything that is suitable to human experience, then the message gets lost somewhere. So if we need to capture the message from any experience, then we need to take that memory to a level of an experience with a moral, with a learning,
so that the next moment gets the better version of oneself. That's my understanding of memories and experiences. Just to connect with you people and with myself at a level of bridge, I had deep vein thrombosis in the year 2000. Everybody kept telling me, oh, Jyoti, at the age of 25, you've got deep vein thrombosis. What would you do the entire life? And somehow I felt that deep vein thrombosis in the year 2000 was my best friend. And I kept telling everybody that, no, this is my best friend, because just because of this ailment, I could realize so many other things in my life. So experiences should be made memories with messages, but not bad or good. That's my experience. I prompt all of you to connect with memories in the, at the same level. Thank you so much. Over to you, Toastmaster Nelson.
Thank you very much, team Jyoti. Nice personal experience you shared us. Very nice. And next, we go. We move to that volunteer, TM Bidu. TM Bidu, your question is, why do we dream? TM Bidu, your question is, why do we dream? You got the question?
Thank you, Toastmasters. Table topic master. Why do we dream? Because it is a scientific reason behind it. I don't want to go into the scientific details of why we dream, but I think there are a lot of good things that we can take out of our dreams. If you see some of the most successful people, they always talk about one factor. They talk about passion, and which comes from the dreams that they had in childhood. And that again takes us to the fact that we dream as a child and then we dream as an adult. But most of the dreams that we had as a child are very much, I would say, novel, because we are yet to figure out the world. And from the very least information that we are getting, we are trying to comprehend something, and those things are developing as, in our mind as a dream. But as we grow up, because we are more into overthinking, a lot of information is cluttered in our brain. We usually find dreams which are not very good to talk about. But I feel if we positively take note of what we are dreaming and stitch it together to see if those dreams should guide us forward, or we should work on our mind to make sure we don't get those bad dreams, it would really help us sleep better. With this, I hand over to you, Table Topic Master Nelson.
Thank you very much, Vidu. Nice explanation. And due to time consideration, I close this session. Thank you very much. Over to T.O. Modi.
Wow. Amazing, Toastmaster Nelson. Such an, I think every topic was so different and so connecting. Thank you so much for coming up with amazing topics and great engagement. I will quickly cover one important part of this conversational intelligence and then move over to the next section. So there are three levels of conversation, as Judith has proposed, and it really impacted me. If you are also, if you're able to understand that, I'm sure it is going to help all of us. So the first level, what she says, is it's called transactional conversations. Most of our conversation, if you see, is just an exchange of information. Even sometimes I see mentor is just asking, hey, have you finished your speech? Have you done this? Have you done that? Boss and corporate culture, right? There it is always ask and tell dynamic. The goal is inform rather than to persuade. And this takes the kind of form of confirmation. One person will say, yeah, done, not done. I'll do next week. I'll do next month. So that's what is the transactional conversation. The second level of conversation, which she says that we should try moving to, and many people are there, which is called positional conversation, which is just not about the exchange of information, but it is also exchange of power. If let's say if I am a boss and I'm talking to my reportee, then even if I'm giving her or him an option of speaking, but then I know what is going to be the outcome. It is in my head, this is going to be the outcome. The conversation is geared toward persuasion, with someone advocating or defending a point of view. And it's common in this conversation level to retreat into protective behaviors. So most of the time appraisal discussions, if you see, it actually goes into that mode. Anyway, he's not going to listen. if they feel that the other person is biased against their point of view. And this is where the last level of conversational intelligence comes, which is called transformative conversation. And this is very dynamic and collaborative. So rather than being confrontational, burdened by power imbalance as in level two, level three involves sharing information back and forth, working together towards a new idea, creating shared solution to our problems, co-creating solutions. Even I don't know what will be the solution, even the other guy doesn't know the solution. We'll sit together and find a solution. The share and discover dynamics present in a level three conversation require that everyone is involved, open, and comfortable. So this is the power of three levels of conversation intelligence. And President Mayur has pinged our contacts. Do connect, do like the page and all the links that he has shared. And also I've shared Subhadeep's coffee podcast. And also I've shared a link to the ebook around this conversation intelligence. It's a big book and it costs around 2000 or something, but it's a free ebook, a summary if you want to go through it. All right, and then let's move to the next section, and which is the evaluation. And for evaluation, we have general evaluator who is going to evaluate everything that has happened today. So let's invite our general evaluator, Toastmaster, and Mr. G. Hitendra Maliwal.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Vinit. First of all, I want to commend you on sticking through the theme of this session. Conversational intelligence. Amazing job. Right from start till end, you didn't miss a bit calling out conversational intelligence and sharing the information about it. It's really amazing. Great job by you, Timod. And I think everybody, especially our speakers, must be waiting for their evaluation, speech evaluation. So let's go to our speech evaluators. Evaluator one, Toastmaster Akash, evaluating Toastmaster Joseph.
Once again, good evening, Toastmaster, and thank you, Toastmaster Hitesh, for the opportunity. So it was a replay of the same event which I was part of, that my target speaker, Joseph sir, has given. Laughter, living, and learning. He started with this theme, which he mentioned. He had an energetic start. He had great clarity in whatever he said in his speech. And he mentioned in the speeches, in his speech, like which pointed out the planning he had done. That is, well in advance, he started planning for this project. So he made points which justifies those planning he has done. So he had made standby role takers for the role takers in case of worst case scenarios of network instability. All these things comes under a good planning of the project. He mentioned about the appreciation that was done by the keynote speaker during the and at the end of the event, which acknowledged the fact that it was a very successful event, and that point made the speech even more effective, I felt. So the speech, the project involved having the humorous speech contestant winners in the panel discussion. He ensured that the humor content was maintained by the panel discussion moderator, DTM Milind, and that was a good way to explain the situation there, and it was a great takeaway to all the guests. So he has used good usages, which I could note, which is limited, like endeavor, palatable, exonerate, which I could note. Only suggestions or what I can suggest from my observation is like I felt that he missed the gestures. He was holding his hand down always, and so he could make use of hand gestures during his speech is what I felt. And I felt that in between there was a little bit swing when he was speaking. That if we make a note, I think it will be a great speech altogether. And I'm expecting more great such great speeches from him. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Akash. You have been a great observer. All the things that you observed, it was amazing, all the details you captured from his speech. So that was great. And Joseph, sir, what to say? You must be a meticulous planner and record keeper. I'm very sure. I couldn't believe you noted every person, every TM, DTM in the guiding committee and talked about the specific date, about the event and everything. Amazing job there. As Toastmaster Akash said, I think working on the technical aspects, your gestures were not visible. And also, I think you were looking, I think your camera is at one place and your probably screen where you look at others, us, that's a different place. So maybe you want to try looking into the camera. But apart from that, I think a great speech. It was a detailed project report. Amazing job. Now let's call our evaluator two for the day. Evaluator Toastmaster Bidu for evaluating Toastmaster Subhadeep's speech.
Thank you, General Evaluator Toastmaster Hitendra. Toastmaster Subhadeep, the idea of Toastmaster mentoring or being a protege during initial days is a very relatable topic. And I'm sure the members of this meeting will at some stage of their life be a protege or right now mentoring someone. This single fact certainly allows you to prepare a topic which can connect us with us really well, but also gives you an added pressure to live up to the potential. Let me tell you, your speech was wonderfully crafted and very aesthetically delivered. Now, going into the deeper aspects of your speech, there are a lot of positive things that I observed. The first one, it had a very big impact beginning. There was a picturesque setting where you mentioned a girl who was delivering a wonderful speech and how you got inspired to reach that level of potential. You had really impeccable hand gestures and movement. You leaned into the camera when you wanted to emphasize a key point, and you had pointed fingers to emphasize key elements of your speeches. You even used both the hands to give a bird's eye view of the setting where you were involved in delivering certain speeches. Now, coming to the language, your speech had a very chronological order. It started with you entering Toastmasters, you giving your initial speeches, meeting your mentor, going up the ladder in terms of how you deliver speeches, and ended with a wonderful gratitude to your mentor. There were really good words like fathom and comprehend, and was used very nicely in your speeches. At the end, we could all feel the gratitude that you have for your mentor and how you have reached from a level where you are trying to give good speeches to a level now where you have been able to give good speeches, all thanks to your mentor. But as our general evaluator, Toastmasters Hitendra, believes in continuous improvement, I'll give 2 points where you could probably look to improve. The first one, there was a point of your speech where you mentioned how after your first speech, you felt a little bit humiliated. Now, as an audience, I could see that you felt humiliated. I could hear that you could feel humiliated, but I could not feel it. Probably what you can do is probably you can add one more line which emphasizes your feeling so that we can invoke that feeling of humiliation that you had, or probably take a pause so that the feeling of humiliation just resides, because you directly jumped on how you met your mentor and everything changed. So because that was a high impact point of your life, I felt that required a little bit of more intense behavior, either a pause or one more line. And the second, the relationship dynamic between your mentor and when you were a protege. So your speech, obviously, there was a lot of gratitude, but I believe when someone meets the mentor, there is a little bit of ice breaking. There's a little bit of point of time where we have apprehensions to reach out to them. And then probably we have a lot of friendly relationship. So I felt rather than going incremental in your relationship, you directly jump to the great bond that you have, and probably could have highlighted the initial point where you were a little bit questioning yourself whether to ask questions or not. And that could have really helped us understand your relationship. Apart from that, as I mentioned earlier, a lot of people are your mentors or are proteges, and I'm sure they would have found a lot of nuggets to take from your speech. All the best, and over to you, Toastmasters, General Evaluator Toastmasters Hitendra.
To the point, Toastmaster Bidu. Amazing. It feels like, you know, same minds think alike. I felt the same thing, you know, the how the relationship evolved between you and your mentor, Toastmaster Subhadeep. I think that should have come out a little bit more. And I think you ended your speech just within just a little over 5 minutes. So you did have time, and you could have included some details about how really mentor, what extent mentor went and helped you out in your speeches, or made you to come up a lot more confident, right? So I think rest of it, ditto as Toastmaster Bidu said, I think he got the pre-evaluation very well done. And one more thing to point out, right? I think you were giving your speech while sitting. So if you stand up and give your speech, that your expressions, your body language will be a lot more visible. Maybe you want to try that next time whenever you give your speeches. And I think we just last week we learned from, I forgot her name. We had the training on the virtual speeches, right? I think she also talked about it, how to raise the table level and laptop level, everything, how to manage the virtual speech presence, etc. So yeah, you may want to try those learnings in the upcoming sessions.
Linda, her name is.
Linda, yes, that's correct. Thank you, Toastmaster Joseph. And I see Toastmaster Subhadeep, you are in pain. So I'm so sorry for that. Hope you feel better soon. Okay, let's move to the rest of the session, right? Amazing job. You started 30 seconds before the scheduled time. So you are very particular on time. And I was watching throughout the session, the agenda topics were actually just 1 or 2 minutes or even few seconds here and there, but you are running completely on time. That is amazing job by this club. And I think I've seen this in the past also. So really great job. You're maintaining that very well. So SAA Sushma, you had great energy. You introduced the club president really well. That was a smooth transition. The ground rules you called out, very well done. After that, we had Toastmaster Mayur, President Mayur, coming and talking about the theme. And I was just completely, I was just listening, you know, how many types of intelligence you told. And I was totally surprised. So that was really good information. Thanks for sharing that. I wish you did not have the connectivity issues, but it was very well done. Next, you covered your announcements as well during this session. So the only thing I observed is there was one announcement on the newsletter, the very first one that you talked about. It felt like it should, it was more like a one-on-one instruction or one-on-one thing that you want to talk to the person who is writing the newsletter. Maybe in the broader session, you want to exclude such announcements and take it up one-on-one with the particular member who is working on it. But other than that, I think rest of the three announcements were very valuable for all the Toastmasters around renewal, table topic contest, and the contest and judges training. I think that was really good. I hope everybody takes advantage of that now that you know there are trainings happening. And then you've smoothly transitioned it over to Toastmaster Vinith. And then Toastmaster Vinith, I already said about you. Conversational intelligence, just amazing job continuing to be with the theme all through the session and connecting after every speech to the theme. That was a very well done job by Toastmaster Vinith. And I would have been very happy if nobody reminded you of general evaluation sections. Okay, coming to our speeches, I think we already talked about our speeches. Let's go to our TAC team for their report before we move on to the table topic section. May I have timer, Nitin, present your report?
Yeah, sure. I'm sharing my screen. Huh? Yeah, is it visible to you, my screen?
Yes.
Yeah. So about the timer report, so the surgeon at arms, Dr. Sushma, is very good at her time. The presiding officer, because of maybe all the announcement, it took 42 seconds more, and not an issue. Joke master, it took 36 seconds. That was a deficiency, and the other things were perfect on time. So coming to the prepared speeches, in the starting, the evaluators got it in time, and there was no deficiencies. In the prepared speeches, speaker one, Toastmaster Joseph, he took 12 seconds more. And I think it is good to put your speech to 5 to 6 minutes, 6 to 7 minutes. And speaker two, Toastmaster Shubhadeep, it was only 5 minutes and 18 seconds. So I think he can extend his speech so that he can cover more than 6 minutes. And coming to the evaluation reports, where evaluator one, Toastmaster Akash, took 3 minutes, 28 seconds, and evaluator two, Toastmaster Bidu, took 3 minutes, 47 seconds. So I see both the evaluations, there are deficiencies. So it is better to not to have such many deficiencies. And coming to the table topic session, it is completely to only 12 to 15 minutes, but the complete session took 17 minutes and 24 seconds, where it was a big kind of deficiency, 2 minutes, 24 seconds. Maybe there are small deficiencies in all the speeches, but there were very great speeches. And that was very good table topics by Toastmaster Nelson. And tag team report, as of now, general evaluator Toastmaster Hitendra, his report took 5 minutes, 22 seconds, with there was a deficiency of 2 minutes and 22 seconds. Thank you. Over to you, general evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nitin. And this was actually the reason I requested Toastmaster Nitin to present the timer report. If you observe, I think first thing is kudos to all of you, pat on your backs, because all of us, all of you are passionate speakers. Speakers as well as evaluators, as well as table topic speakers. All of you are passionate speakers, but I think all of us need to make sure we are within those time limits. So that time management perspective of communication should be learned by all of us. And before I move forward to the AHA counter report, I would like to commend Joke Master Vandana as well. Thank you for your little story on the marriage proposal. And that was a BKM, I would say, short hairs and, you know, done. That was great. So let's move to the AHA counter report. We have Toastmaster.
Can I go ahead?
Sorry, go ahead. Adarsh.
Once again, greetings to everybody. I'm playing the role of an arc counter today, as you already know, and I've been paying attention to all of you so closely. And I think my heart sank at the start of the session because I was not able to find any arc counts at all. I was struggling so hard. There was a time where I even turned off the camera to come very close to my laptop to see whether there was anybody using any arc counts, and I was able to find some towards the end of the session. So I'm going to quickly run through all the speakers and table topic speakers and point out the R counts and the other crutch words they managed to use during their speeches and table topics. Joseph, sir, I was not able to notice any R counts in your speech, so kudos. Shubhadeep, I thought that your speech was very fluent from start to finish. I thought it was very tidy, great work. I was not able to find any crutch words. TM Nelson, I was able to find one crutch word that I think you've had a bout with for a long time. And I think that's the word R. You've been using it quite a lot, but I'm pretty confident that you'll improve as time goes on. You managed to use around 13 R counts. Going to our table topic speakers, we had Munish, who didn't use any R counts or any crutch words during his table topic. Great work. Oryojit, I was able to spot around 9 R counts, but I was not able to spot anything else aside from that. So please go ahead and work on that. Elango, I was not able to find any R counts, but I was able to find one crutch word, and that was you know, and you only used it once. Vandana, she played the role of a joke master, and at the same time, she was our table topic speaker. She managed to use around 9 R counts. She used one and then I was able to hear you know on a couple of occasions. So it comes to a total of around 12 crutch words, not 12 crutch words. It's only 3 crutch words, but it was used around 12 times. So please go ahead and work on that. Great work, by the way. Jyoti, I was not able to find any crutch words during a table topic. I thought it was very crisp. I thought it was absolutely brilliant. Great work. TM Bidu, I had a hard time finding any crutch words when you spoke. In fact, that was, again, you were one of those people that drove me crazy during today's session. I was not able to find any accounts except for one crutch word, which was and you only used it once towards the end. As for our timer, Nitin, I was able to hear the R count on about 5 occasions. So I'm pretty confident that you're working very hard on it, because I think I've gone from using about 10 hours in a speech or a table topic to using around 5. So great work on that. And moving forward to our general evaluator for the day, TM Hitendra, I was able to hear around 9 R counts. By the way, I was not able to hear anything at the start. I thought it was very crisp. I thought it was absolutely brilliant the way you went about things, but I think it was towards the end when the number of accounts increased. So I'm sure you're already working on it, just like everybody else. Our evaluator number one, Akash, used around 9 hours, and there was nothing else aside from that. So finally, I would like to point out one person that had the most screen time during today's session. So it was none other than our TMod, Vineet. Again, I was finding it very, very difficult to look for any accounts or any crutch words for that matter. So please give yourself a pat on the back, because I thought you were absolutely brilliant. I was not able to find any crutch words whatsoever. So great work, and back to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Adarsh. What a great report. And you have really good ears listening to all ahas and pointing out everything. And the best thing you did, I would say, is you remembered how the person was doing earlier and you're telling the improvements. So that was really an amazing job. Let's go to our grammarian and Toastmaster Joseph, sir.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, General Evaluator. I think everybody is a really great student of Renan Martin, who never commits any grammatical mistake, but a little bit is there, but I will tell it later on. The good words used is illuminated, effortlessly, nascent stages, super excited, numb, humiliation, plunged, critic, skeptic, comprehend, inculcate, a manner, enchantment, pertinent, obsession, relishing, impassioned, exonerating, greatly palatable, exhilarate, indefatigable, endeavor, invoke, intent, behavior, apprehension, great bond, level of nuggets. So these are some of the good words used already. And the phrases are waterfall, fountain, world was spinning, cycle of learning, hope with yourself. Then we have a level of bridge, every experience gives us the message. These are some of the praises. Out of box, walk like beast, they eat like a pig. Of course, this could not have been used actually. That will be hurting the feelings. Out of box is some of the phrases. Then I have some suggestions. I am hoping you could also say, I hope. That would be a nice way to use. Some people are using guys. Usually the Toastmaster, I think, never encourages the word guys in the meeting. The golden rule is not, it can be called house rule or cardinal rule. So don't call golden rule. Basically, I'm landing is not the correct word. Usually I land, because basically gives another meaning. What, without being defensiveness is it could be without being defense or defenseless or something like that. How the session run is how the session go. Team of tag should be, tag team. That would be the correct word. Then we have nice, rather than we had nice, so-and-so. then given it my best could be given my best. So these are some of the things that could be corrected and used very well. That's all for the day. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Joseph, for that detailed report. By any chance, did you notice how many people use word of the day?
I am the only one you used.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so again, probably everybody is encouraged to use word of the day going forward. And I think it was a difficult word, so we couldn't use. And Joseph, sir, very commendable job taking up a speaker role as well as grammarian role. I think it's tough. And you did phenomenal job. Great work there. Coming to our table topics, Master, Toastmaster Nelson. Wow, your table topics were great. And I would say every table topic speaker was amazing. Which I don't have words for any one of you. You literally spoke like a prepared speech, and it was so flawless and smooth. So I was, you probably all of you are table topic contest winners for me. Amazing job by all the table topic speakers. Okay, so I think overall, all this in the entire session went well. I feel very smooth. There were two things I noticed which can be definitely improved for the entire session perspective. One is the Zoom pinning issue, pinning the timer. I think that's not working out for speaker. We may have to find out some alternative. And the second thing is Toastmaster Ilangon has a green background. So a couple of times I got confused whether the speech timer time is up or what. So maybe that's something everybody should not keep. There should not be any background which is conflicting with the timer report cards or the timer backgrounds. That's pretty much from the general evaluator's desk. And I hope I didn't badmouth anyone. It was just a constructive feedback for our continuous improvement. Thank you all. Back to you, Toastmaster of the day. Toastmaster Vinay.
Awesome. Thank you so much. I've not seen such a comprehensive report by GE and TAG report. Amazing. I think we all got so many feedbacks today. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Hitendra. And the best part for me was even the feedbacks were constructive and was in a very smiling manner. So I really never felt that it was a feedback. Thank you so much for that. Let's go. I know we are just running out of time, so I'll just quickly end my theme of the day, which is building trust with conversation and intelligence. So I talked about level 3 conversation of share and discover, and that is where trust is built. And learning to prime the brain for trust, partnership, and mutual success is a powerful skill. With this knowledge, we can create conversation to support more productive, co-creative, and intelligent results in our professional, personal, and even Toastmasters journey. So with that, over to our amazing president, Toastmaster Mayur.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Vinit and Toastmaster of the day. It was wonderful to hear your theme and we all of us got a lot of information from the theme, and we can take from this theme a lot of things. I thank every role taker for doing their job commendably, especially Toastmaster of the day, general evaluator, and tag team. And I am very impressed with both the speaker of our today's meeting, Toastmaster Joseph and Toastmaster Shubhadeep. And I enjoyed the speaker evaluation by Toastmaster Akash and Toastmaster Bidu as well. With that, now I would like to invite our voting master, if the voting links are ready, and is it already shared by her in the chat box. If you haven't voted yet, please vote
yes,
out
I
soon.
Yes, I have shared.
Yeah. Can anybody vote for me, for my vote?
Okay. We count your one vote for your speech. Whatever votes you will receive, we will add +1 to it, as
Thank
always.
You. Thank you, Mayur.
Thank you. Sushma, when you are ready, please tell me. I would like to thank all the guests who are...
Mayur, yes. Sorry for the interruption. I have posted the link in the chat box.
Yes,
you
yes. Can you share?
Yeah, I have shared it too.
Yes.
Please cast your vote, guys. I have also shared again in the chat box. Once she will get a collective responses, then we will announce the result. Meanwhile, I would like to thank all of our guests joining us from different cities or clubs. Munish, thank you for joining us. Ilango, Ashwini, I think Ashwini and some people left in between. Stella, thank you for joining us. So could anyone tell me how was your experience joining us today as a guest? Stella, Munish, Ilango.
Yeah. Thank you, President. And thanks to the Speech Weavers Toastmasters Club. It was a wonderful meeting. The Toastmaster of the day, he gave amazing information and knowledge about conversations. It really is a great takeaway for me. And of course, the evaluation sessions, the speeches were excellent. And I think Toastmaster Joseph, I think he is going to complete this speech pathways. Congratulations to you, sir. And I really enjoyed the session, right? And surprised that he came in just before the roll was called, and he did a great job as a grammarian. Amazing, sir. Even the tag team reports were excellent, actually. The way you presented was amazing. I really love the way, the discipline, the commitment that this club is bringing, and it's brought everybody together. The table topics, my God, the tabletop speeches, excellent. Kudos to the entire team, to the club as a whole. Thank you for having me also in this wonderful evening. All the best to all of you guys.
Thank you so much, Ilango, for your wonderful words. Sushma, how many votes we have got?
Mayur, tell Sushma to add my vote also.
Yes, yes, I will add, don't worry. Sushma, how many votes did you got? Okay, meanwhile, Sushma will come. Let me announce our Toastmaster of the month for June and July. Our Toastmaster month for June was Toastmaster Nilu. She did a commendable job on giving so many speeches in the club as well as in external club as well. She also took a lot of different various roles in the club and won various category award in the meeting as well by giving best speeches or evaluation or table topic speaker. And congratulations, Toastmaster Nilu. Now I would like to announce our Toastmaster of the month for the July, and she won. She is Toastmaster Vandana. Congratulations to you on winning the Toastmaster of the month for July. Can you share the poster, Akash? Thank you. Congratulations, Vandana. She also took a lot of roles and took various roles in the external club and gave speeches. Kudos to you. Congratulations and all the best for upcoming meetings and months. Sushma, are the votes counted?
I think there is some problem. Just I'm checking that. I could not see any. Just can you check? I could not see that though.
Okay. So the as Hitendra also noted about the announcement of the newsletter, I just want to clarify on this that you have to submit your article. It is not specific to any member. I was just announcing that you have to just submit your article by 15 September, and please review your article before submitting to PR team and check your grammar or vocabulary before submitting to us. Just a second, I will also check what is happening with the votings.
So everybody submits an article, is it?
Yeah, it's depend. Whoever want to submit, they can submit, and not compulsory for anyone.
Okay, great. I thought there is one specific person who is going to write newsletter article. My bad.
I'm checking. I'm not able to. Is there anything has gone wrong? The link is exact only. Or you want me to post the link one more time?
One second. Okay, I am not able to find the link in the drive. So we will take offline voting if possible, and we will take votes later. Thank you, everyone.
You want me to, one more time, you want me to generate?
Yeah, we will take it offline. Okay. Sushma, don't worry.
Okay.
So thank you, everyone, for joining us today at Speech Weaver. I hope you have guys enjoyed our meeting today. With that, I am closing meeting 6:27. And thank you for joining us.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you. It was a great session. Have a good weekend, all.
Guys.
Thanks, Hitendra. Thank you so much.
Hey, one sec before I drop. Toastmaster Vandana.
Yeah.
Any thoughts on winning the Toastmaster of the Month award?
Yeah, I had no clue that I was winning it. Because see, I work, Akash and me, we discuss PR a lot and all that. So he's preparing the poster. He also didn't tell me and didn't appear. So I had no clue. So what happened is I put a target for myself. Every month I'll do one speech. So like tomorrow I'm giving a speech in Indranagar club. So sometimes we do one speech in our club and one speech in another club. Then people keep messaging me to take up roles. Sometimes I have to say. So it is because they've asked me, like Indranagar Pride and Delhi Sukti, generally we have a good, bond. And lot of times I speak, I used to come, but after I started working, it's been difficult. So I think the clubs we interact with, they keep asking to take up roles. But every meeting, I take up a role. I think that is the only thing that worked.
That's great.
Not with a target.
I was just trying to connect to your table topic, evaluating yourself. You are never happy with yourself. Yeah, you should be happy now.
Yeah, I am happy. That's what so the ending was.
Prisma,
like,
can
was like,
you stop recording?
Oh, sorry. I thought recording was stopped.